Good day, everyone. I still remain the Chela Priest. Ambassador of truth. Poison to evil. I say the truth, no matter who you are, I say it to your face. I don't care who you are. Pastors, religions are my enemy and are African enemies. Today I'm talking about spiritual wife. Spiritual husband, that is spiritual spouse. Why we have spiritual husband, why we have spiritual spouse, what they mean, what is our link with us to them. Spiritual spouse, you know, before you come to this earth, like I said in my past video, we have four elements: fire, earth, water, and air. Before you came to this world, you were a spirit. And many of us in the spiritual realm, we got married before coming to the physical realm. Especially those that are from the water realm. 70% of human beings are from the water realm. Because water is one of the most powerful elements. Dual elemental beings. Let's assume you came through water portal. You are from water, and you, before you were sent to the world, you got married. And when you were going, you took an oath that when I go to the world, before I get to 15 years, or before I get married, I will come and give my spiritual husband his settlement. And the god, the goddess of the queen of the marine kingdom, settlement. Because you have gifts, you're supposed to give them. Because they're the one that makes sure that you came to the world successful and have been protecting you all your life till you go back to the dark realm. So people forget, you won't remember this code. That is why. In the olden days, before we do anything, we go for consultation. Before we do any business, we go for consultation. Before we get married, we go for consultation to know if that partner you want to get married to, he or she destiny, the two destinies match together. Or which the spiritual spouse will allow. Let's assume you took an oath that when you get married, you settle your spiritual spouse, you come and take permission from him. And you said to the queen of the marine kingdom, and you came and you get married, you didn't do that. Although you won't know, that's why it's good to go for consultation. Because before you come to the world, you're wiping out your memory, and your guardian spirit will hold that memory. That is only the only reason why they did that is only God Almighty. Nature that knows that. So when you get married and you start living your life, they'll get angry. They'll carry your keys to spiritual court. And when they win you in the court and collect permit, they get permitted to torment you. They'll start tormenting you. They'll report you to spiritual task and you start getting tormented. Is it that the woman start facing problem, child difficulty, getting pregnant, or they might even make her run mad. Her life will be miserable. If the husband guardian spirit is not strong, if the man that is good in good time with his guardian spirit, they'll not be able to harm the man. They'll harm the husband is not in good time with the guardian spirit, they'll make the man collapse. The man will be so poor that there's nothing we lay his hand on that will go. We'll be begging to feed. Spiritual spouses are very, very powerful. But the moment you realize this and you went to that river of your incarnation and present that sacrifice to them, the sacrifice of the queen of the marine kingdom, your spiritual spouse, and your marine set, and you ask your spiritual spouse that I've given your sacrifice. Allow me to marry here on earth. When I grow old and die, I'll come back to you. What you do is continue guiding me. Open way for you. Bless me. You see that by doing that, things will turn around. The two people are high. Person will start progressing. People will say that this person is doing it. No. Because he has done the right thing. He has done the needful. But if you are moving from one pastor, those people that call themselves men of God. So, instead of pastors to tell them the truth, that look at what you do to solve the problem of spiritual spouse, they'll be giving them prayer point. Instead of pastor, the Reverend Father to tell you the truth, that look at the way to go about to solve this issue, the spiritual spouse issue, they'll give you prayer point. Now when you start praying and be guiding and be casting some that spirit that you are going, your problem will start getting worse. It will now become from fry pan to fire. I don't know the type of and mostly it happens to people that illiterate, people when they go to school, now their own worst parts. Yeah, you think that as they are firing that spiritual spouse, where the water will catch fire. Sense where you no get. Stop it to go and make peace with them. Even though you don't have money to do it yet, why not pick up cola? Go to that water of reincarnation. Call on them. Tell them to give you time. They should rather open way for you. Ask them for forgiveness for not knowing earlier about your oath taking. Tell them that one, you promise them that when they open way for you, you will do the needful. If you are far away from that river of your incarnation, use anywhere you are, call, raise that collar to the sun and call on them. This same thing happened when your guardian spirit is disturbing you too. Everyone needs to do what? Go back to their way of worship. If your spiritual spouse is disturbing you and you go for consultation, you go to any prayer house and tell your spiritual spouse is disturbing you, all you need to look for is a very good spiritualist. I'm not talking about a pastor. A priestess or a priest that has a staff of authority to offer sacrifice to water. They will take you to a river of incarnation. First of all, they will consult that your spiritual spouse and ask them the requirement of what the sacrificial items they needed. And when you present it to them, you see that your problem is solved. But it doesn't end there. You'll be going there once in a while to also do what we call pray yoma. Pray for progress. Noting that we can go to a water that you are from, promise them that you give them goods when things turn around for you. And you go and you see that in the twinkling of an eye, that thing will happen. It's not charm. African spirituality is not about charm. It's about connecting ourselves to nature, knowing more about nature, giving nature and collecting from nature, giving nature, trade, just like trade by barter between humans and nature, because we need them just as they need us. You cannot fight a spiritual spouse. What those ones will say, well, you should need to separate you from your spiritual spouse. That is the worst problem. You cannot get separated. Separation is it when you are trying to do that, you are making your situation worse. They can even kill you or run you mad. Many women today are barren today because of spiritual spouse. Many women today are facing different kind of illness today because of spiritual spouse. Many women today have bad character just because of spiritual spouse. Many women today are facing challenges in their home from their in-laws just because of spiritual spouse. Same as men. Many men are suffering today because of spiritual spouse. Many men don't get, there's nothing they'll lay their hands on that will go because of spiritual spouse. Even though you give them 10 million to put in business, it will crumble. Spiritual spouse. And that same foolish people will still carry Bible and carry and start firing and binding and casting. And do you know the funniest part? Their children will start emulating them. Instead of positive, the children should be attracting positive energy, you'll be attracting negative energy. Each time you'll be beating your children, you'll be correcting them. And they'll continue making that same thing because of you have attracted negative forces to them. You've provoked their elemental beings. If you're a man, you're facing spiritual wife problem, go and make peace with her. If you're a woman, you're facing spiritual spouse problem, go and make peace with your spiritual husband. It's not an evil thing. You cannot defeat them. You cannot kill them. You cannot cage them. If you continue binding and casting, you will remain a poor man till you die. And you die, and any person that die a poor man is the worst death. When you go back to your spiritual realm, they will flog nonsense out of your body. Because you didn't live the life you took an oath to live. If a pastor claim is that powerful, let him go inside one water and drown. Whether they no go in the water no go drown. Since you say water is evil, it's powerless. Africans need to wake up. Parents, save your children's future today. When your child is coming of age, 2 to 3 years, make a peace with that child's spiritual spouse. Make peace with that child guardian spirit. So that when that child is growing out, the potentials of that child will be coming out. Before you know, they'll be fighting for the child, for who will give the child scholarship. I will stop here today. That's all about spiritual spouse. I've made I'm married today, and my wife made peace with her spiritual spouse. You know, there's some people that if you didn't make peace with your spiritual spouse, if you like, get 10 filling station, go crumble. They are very powerful. Now, what thing you they see, now you feel fight. You know, if you fight, what thing you know, see. You they cast and bind.
Excuse me.
You know, see. You are wasting time. That will be all for today. I believe. May God Almighty and Mother Africa help us see the truth. Thanks for today.
Excuse me, Desert, you have an incoming call. Excuse me, Desert, you have...
See you some other time. I believe you enjoyed my teaching for today. See you next time. See you remain the digital priest.